Hey guys, this is Mike Tarallo with Qlik, and in this video, I'm going to walk you through a very quick example of how to create your first app with Qlik Sense Business. So once you've registered and logged into the hub, you'll be greeted with a welcome to Qlik Sense message where you have some quick links to other resources as well as your content area. Now your content and favorites most likely will be blank if this is a new tenant that you've set up. Don't forget, there is a full deeper dive product tour available on YouTube and the Qlik community. I will make sure to include the link in the description of this video. So to get started, all we're going to do is click the Create button in the upper right, and you'll have an option to create an app or upload an app. You also have an option to create a link to another resource. We're going to focus on creating an app within the environment, and we give the app a name. I'll just call this Sales Dashboard 2020, and we'll choose a space. Now at this point, you probably won't have any spaces available, so you can just choose the personal space, and there are other videos and resources that go into deeper dives on spaces. I'll leave the description blank and the tags blank, and just click Create. Now you'll see the banner here. You can click this button to open it, or you can just simply click on the tile, and it'll bring you into a familiar looking app overview interface, which will prompt you to add data. So at this point, we're just going to use some file data. And off screen, I have a data folder. So I'll bring that into view. And I'm just going to grab a simple getting started and just drop it right onto the canvas. And it brings you into the main design interface. Now this data, which I will make available in the community post, has been formatted to work with this particular example. Depending on the data that you have, you might have to massage it a little bit better with the data tools. Now, at this point, you can start creating your particular charts and visualizations, and there are a number of ways to go about that. You can simply just click the Generate Insight button and look at the suggested charts, or you can start typing in a particular question. In this case here, I can just say, show me sales to keep it simple and press Enter. And what it'll do is create a KPI object, which we could then add to the sheet. It'll also make other suggestions based off of the profiling that it learned. Please note, this is a very quick demonstration of getting data into the app. We have more detailed videos on other features and capabilities that I'm showing you. So here we can just add to sheet, and then we can also click edit. Now, if we do that, we have our assets panel and we have our properties panel. If I just go into the assets panel and click charts, you can see the variety of different visualizations. You can drag and drop these and then configure them manually, or you can also use the power of our cognitive engine to automatically create the visualization for you by simply dropping the measures and dimensions onto the canvas. Just to give you a quick example, if a chart has been created with chart suggestions turned on, in this case here, I can turn it on. And then if I grab another dimension, in this case like category, and drop it on a visualization that's already been created, it'll make the next best representation of that chart. In this case, we're comparing dimensional values for category, so it creates a bar chart. Another quick example, if I grab product name, which is underneath category, in other words, products exist within categories, and I drop it onto the same visualization, it'll now create a tree map because there's sort of a parent-child relationship in there. You could always override additional property settings by shutting off chart suggestions as well. And you could also, in this case here, copy and then paste using Control C and Control V, and then start building off these other chart objects. Lastly, I'm just going to show you a quick example of just creating a chart manually. In this case here, I'm going to grab a scatter plot, drop it onto my canvas, and you can see we have these quick buttons. Let's say we're going to look at this information by country. And we're going to use the measure of sales, and we're going to aggregate sales. And then I'm going to create another measure because we're looking at a correlation between sales, in this case, margin. And now we have our scatter plot. Now at this point here, I can go into the data area. I could reposition my measures as so. I could expand my measures and change the formatting options. So for example, margin will be a number and a percentage. And sales will be formatted as money. I could even put a label such as total sales. Okay, so that's all I wanted to spend. Quick 5-minute video just to show you how quickly you can get data into the product and you can start creating those visualizations. For a deeper dive on all of these capabilities, please check out our other resources on the Qlik community, our help channel, and YouTube. If you have any comments or questions, please post them in the comments area where this video is made available, either in the community or YouTube. Thanks for your time, guys. Take care.